to address this little problem with Gabe's thing. Oh yeah, and he's also retightened that rim. This is the one that he bent, like as you saw in the flashback. It's vlog 12. Some guy was frantically honking at us and yelling us to get over. And he's like, dude, your wheel's going to fall off. Which isn't really true, but maybe true at the same time, considering the fact that with this thing wobbling, it may loosen the lug nuts up. So he's going to tighten it up. So just picked up my tools, switched out my blood-stained shirt. Now it's off to the junkyard.
Painted red, the stripe was white, it was 18 feet from the bow to the stern light. Second hand from a dealer in Atlanta, I rode up with Daddy when he went there to get her. Put on a shine, put on a motor, built out of love and made for the water. Ran her for years till her transom got rotten. A piece of my childhood that'll never be forgotten. It was just an old plywood boat, the 75 Johnson with electric choke. A young boy, two hands on the wheel. I can't replace the way it made me feel. And I would turn her sharp, I'd make it whine. He'd say, you can't beat the way an old wood boat rides. Just a little lake across the Alabama line, but I was king of the ocean when Daddy let me drive.
We're over here in the east side of Salt Lake Valley. We're seeing absolutely beautiful cars out here. We saw a 55 Chevy with a completely black, and then it had some flames on it. And then just back there in the shop, we saw a 50s GMC truck. So now we're just looking for the junkyard, which no one Google Maps, there's probably no pick and pull on the east side of town. Because look, it's basically all city out here. Why would there be a junkyard? Why would there be a junkyard in the middle of the city? Then again, we do see farm fields in the middle of the city too. Another little update here. We couldn't find the pick and pull, so we're like, forget it. Just go somewhere else. We were on the side of town though where my grandfather lives. He has some awesome vehicles. Like he has a 05 GTO. That's Pontiac for you, some of you guys. And then a 1967 Buick Riviera. Then a 1966 Buick Electra. Then I know this isn't that interesting. He also has a 95 Chevy Tahoe that only has 40,000 miles on it. So, it was my idea to go see him, but we decided not to, but maybe that'll be a future vlog very soon, because school's going to be out soon, and Gabe and I might skip out on the last 2 days of school, since they don't take roll anyways. But now, we're not going to go to Pick and Pull, we're going to go to Pull and Save, which is what we just saw on the 201 freeway on our way out here, Utah 201. So we're just on... Are we on I-15?
I don't know where we are.
It's probably a good thing I'm here too, because I'd say we're on I-15.
Yeah, we're on I-15.
So get into the I-80 lane since you missed 201.
I did not miss 201.
Yes, you did.
You missed us. Shouldn't we be getting that one though?
I don't get what it is, but we have such stupid drivers in Utah. Like, here's an example.
Holy
I didn't even see.
Crap. How big that freaking boat was?
I don't know if that guy's an idiot, but I was just talking about it and that showed up. But the thing is, there's always people cutting you off. Like, we were on a 201, we were getting off of 201 onto I-80, and this lady comes and cuts us off because she's eating a sandwich, and then she goes like, all I see is her mouthing sorry in a smart aleck way.
She didn't even signal, she just started running straight into me.
Yeah.
So now I just swerve out of the way.
Oh my gosh. Oh yeah, and this is really funny. So I went to look at her license plate, but unfortunately I didn't catch it on camera. And her license plate said Blondie. So that's just the irony. That is just funny. So We're gonna keep on going. Make it to pull and save. We're on I-80 now.
It's the junkyard finally. Dave's checking his room size. I got my tools. And we're gonna go in, look for parts that we need, because we both need parts. For example, I need a washer pump, so we're gonna do that. Yeehaw.
We're in the junkyard.
We had to pay to get in, so about $4 for the two of us. They don't have any cars that I need. The earliest model Century they have is a 98, so I'm kind of screwed there. So now we're going to go hunting for a Corolla. So this is interesting. Oh, and look, I'm stupid. I wore shorts today.
Oh, Taylor. Taylor.
Taylor.
Hey, Taylor.
I can't ever predict you.
Oh, yeah, true. I'm unpredictable.
I'd love to have one of these trucks. Oh, dude, look how nice these seats are still. Dude, this is nice.
I just want to take it home with me. Sleep on it.
Luckily, my iPod had plenty of time to charge and stuff.
So yeah, we just got a new
my car all the time, Mitch. Now look whose car is in the junkyard.
Not a nice engine. It's got better engine than you, Taylor.
Yeah. Then why is it in the junkyard? Why isn't mine in the junkyard? It's because it still runs.
Alright, this is it.
It's because there's potential for it to run, that is. That looks like a Camry. Ooh, that's a nasty wreck. I've never seen broken glass like this before, like this up close. What's in here?
I don't know why, but I like that door a lot.
Oh, sweet, it's a coupe. Oh, it's been a wreck. I've never seen an air... Here, let me see.
Let's see what this had.
I've never seen an airbag like that before, like just deployed. Holy mackerel.
Have you ever been to a...
I've never been to a junkyard before.
What? That's where I spent my summer last year. Damn.
That's a straight six.
I
saw one a little while back. There's a Toyota Camry. You need anything, Mom? You say we don't have that much time, and
okay, yeah,
sorry, as you're usual.
Right. You're right. Okay.
There's a Corolla.
It said there's...
Recognize the taillights? 2008 Toyota Black Corolla.
2008?
This is an 08.
I didn't realize there's a tag on it. That's cool.
There's no tires left.
Yeah, there's one right here.
Rims? Is that the exact size we need?
80. Oh, it's right here. I don't think it's the thing.
Maybe we should take some other stuff we might need for your car. Oh wait, that's been picked. I don't know. This one's been in a wreck. I'm not sure if you can see that. Oh, there's the evidence of it. The airbag's out. Huh? Right here. Still good. Yeah, they're a little nicer than yours. Like yours just look like, I don't know what the thing is with them, but maybe you can just trade the seats out. Do those seem a little nicer?
Yeah, they do.
Maybe we can look for an 11 Corolla to help our friend out. 2011. Oh, there's the Corolla seat right there.
The entire engine's gone.
Here, let me get one now. Do you have my tape measure? Good. Dude, if you would just... Dude, if you just come here, do you know how much money... You wouldn't have had to sell your other Corolla.
Spending like you'll learn over time. The more time you spend here, the more impressive.
1990. Oh, this is the exact same one as yours was. 1999 Toyota Corolla.
Dude, Taylor, what if they just took off the rims in this car?
Do you think it'd be the same?
No.
Oh, I see why now. We just put the other tire on to see how it feels. Whether this is going to be a good plan or bust. Which it kind of already well, feels
as good. You can see, the misfire is finally gone, but there is still a problem with it stalling. There's many things that could cause that, like the ignition system or whatever, but listen to how smooth this thing purrs. I'll do another exhaust video.
Oh yeah, I still need to put power steering fluid in it. There we go, probably worked. Well, I hope you've liked this video. If you have, like and subscribe to me, subscribe to Gabe. Have a nice day.